Hey guys, how's it going? New film study video. This time we're going to be looking at Bernard Hopkins versus Felix Trinidad. So with that said, on to the video. Okay, so the first thing we're going to be talking about is how Bernard Hopkins takes away Felix Trinidad's left hook. And he does this basically by using his jab while circling to his left. He's circling to his left, which is Trinidad's right, which basically shuts down Trinidad's left hook. So every time Trinidad looks like he's setting up to shoot a left hook, Hopkins will systematically circle out to his left using his jab, which will shut down the left hook prematurely and neutralize that left hook. Of course, as Hopkins is circling to his left, he's also circling into Trinidad's power right hand. But Bernard Hopkins had a game plan for that right hand, and he felt like he could counter that right hand more easily than he could counter Trinidad's left hook, so he preferred to circle out to his left. So as you can see, he's using the jab to circle out to his left. He doesn't just circle out to his left unprotected. He's staying behind that jab. He's staying behind that lead hand. And of course, as you can see, Felix Trinidad, every time he sets up to shoot that left hook, Bernard Hopkins would circle to his left. But sometimes Hopkins would also walk to his right. And as he's walking to his right, of course, he's walking towards Felix Trinidad's powerful left hook. So Hopkins has to find a way to prevent Felix Trinidad from actually shooting this left hook. And we're going to see how he does that in a moment. So as you can see, he shoots that right hand. Now, the shortest way from point A to point B is a straight line. That's just basic geometry. The straight right usually beats a left hook because it's a straight punch, whereas a hook is a curved punch or an angled strike. So Bernard Hopkins shoots that right hand to make Felix Trinidad very cautious and reluctant to throw his left hook because it's more likely to land the right hand. And now you're going to see my point exactly, because here Bernard Hopkins is going to time Felix Trinidad so perfectly with the right hand, because Felix Trinidad, you're going to see him set up to shoot a left hook, and Bernard Hopkins is going to beat him to the punch with a straight right hand. Like I said, the shortest point from A to B is a right hand or a straight punch. So as you can see, Bernard Hopkins catches him with a straight punch as he's setting up to throw the left hook. And this is what it means to be defensively responsible, because he automatically slips to the outside of Trinidad's right cross, and then he's going to proceed to smother and control Felix Trinidad. As I always say, to be a champion, you have to learn how to control your opponent, because return fire is simply unacceptable, and champions don't take return fire. So Bernard Hopkins right here shows you that you must control your opponent. Okay, now we're going to be talking about the Bernard Hopkins deceptive straight right hand. Now, Hopkins likes to lead with his right hand after he forces his opponent to reset. Now, there's some kind of fighters who fight in the rhythm, and when you break their rhythm, they usually force to reset themselves. Now, Hopkins likes to lead with his right hand when that happens. Usually, or sometimes, he sets this up by stepping back and launching forward as you step forward momentarily off of the reset. So as you can see, Hopkins is going to take a quick step back. Trinidad steps forward, and that's when Hopkins launches the right hand. Notice also that Hopkins has changed levels, so he's actually low, and that actually also further disguises the right hand. But the combination of that plus the deceptive step back is what means that Trinidad actually doesn't see this punch coming. If you look at Trinidad's reaction, you can clearly see that is a reaction of someone who didn't even see this punch. So Hopkins takes that quick step back and then launches as Trinidad steps forward. Now, once again, pay attention to Felix Trinidad's feet. Notice after he resets, he's going to take that step forward. Remember, I just told you how Bernard Hopkins is stepping back at the same time. The combination of stepping back and Trinidad stepping forward, most fighters just don't have the ring IQ and the boxing IQ to actually see that right hand coming. And this is why Bernard Hopkins likes to lead with the right hand at this position. As you can see, he takes a step back and he launches off the toes of his right foot. So that's excellent technique. It takes many, many years of drills to be able to practice to get the power to launch off your toes like this. Now you're going to see here again, Felix Trinidad steps forward and gets caught with the right hand once again. Pay close attention to after Felix Trinidad resets once again. Notice he takes that step forward and he gets caught with the right hand again. This is due to exceptional timing. And as I always say, timing negates speed and power. As you can see, he steps forward and Hopkins catches him with the right hand off of his reset. Great technique from Hopkins. Now Bernard Hopkins is going to show us why it's important to control your opponent and to set up your offense off of the control. So here you're going to see Bernard Hopkins miss with his jab. But the thing is, he doesn't allow Felix Trinidad to capitalize on his mistake. And the best fighters don't allow you to capitalize on their mistakes. So he misses with his jab, but he instantly transitions that lead hand into control. You can see he immediately controls Felix Trinidad's head. This prevents any return fire from Trinidad. And then off of this control, you're going to see him position Felix Trinidad's head in place for a short, sharp right hook. And this is him using control to set up his offense. So now you're going to see him position ahead for that right hook, which is coming right now. And as you can see, he fires a right hook and then he's defensively responsible. So he instinctively slips to the outside of Trinidad's right hand counter because champions don't take return fire. So that was just a quick segment there to show you control. And now here you're going to see him in close with Trinidad. The kind of thing you see from Floyd Mayweather and Adrian Broner where they're fighting in the shell very close up. And he's able to land this beautiful right uppercut. And we're going to break that down. So first you can see that Hopkins is in his shell. Notice that his chin is tucked in behind his left shoulder and his arms can be used to catch punches. Specifically, his left arm can be used to stop and block the uppercut. And the right hand can be used to catch hooks. So as you can see, he's able to deflect that punch. Hopkins now places his left arm on top of Trinidad's left glove. And this is him actually trapping and controlling Felix Trinidad's left arm. This is brilliant skill from Bernard Hopkins. Off of the control, he fires that short right hook and he takes a small step. Did you see that small step back? He takes off the right hook, which allows him to create the space required to follow up with this beautiful right uppercut, which is genius from Bernard Hopkins. Once again, take note of how Hopkins is going to lean in before he shoots that short right hook and then step away from the right hook. That by leaning in and then stepping away, he deceptively disguises the step away and he makes it more explosive and allows him to create the space to shoot the right uppercut.
The end of the round, Bernard Hopkins, patience during that fight.
Okay, now finally, we're going to take a look at how he knocks out Felix Trinidad. So you're just going to see a replay of the knockout a couple times and I'll explain what happened. So this is the first replay. This is the second one. Now basically you can see Bernard Hopkins feints the left uppercut. Then he throws the left uppercut from too far out wide, catches the left hook from Trinidad and follows up with the right hook of his own and drops Trinidad. So you can see he catches Trinidad's left hook and counters with a right hook of his own and knocks out Trinidad. And that is actually planned by Bernard Hopkins. It doesn't look like it, but I'm going to explain that this is a technique Hopkins uses. He throws that left hook to draw the right left hook from Trinidad, and then he counters with a right hook of his own. And the reason why I say that is because you can see him feint the left uppercut here against Antonio Tarver, which draws the left uppercut from Tarver, and then he counters with a right hand of his own. This is actually a technique Bernard Hopkins uses. See, he feints the left uppercut there. It's not good enough, so he then throws the left uppercut from too far out. He's deceptive. He's defensively responsible, catches the left hook, and knocks out Trinidad. Watch again. He feints the left uppercut against Tava. He feints the left uppercut against Trinidad. See? It's the same thing. It's the same move he does. He draws a left uppercut from Antonio Tava, whereas he draws a left hook from Felix Trinidad. He counters with his right hand and takes down Antonio Tarver, knocks him down. Counters with a right hook against Felix Trinidad. Beautiful, beautiful, brilliant skill from Bernard Hopkins.
Oh, huge right hand by Hopkins. Down goes Trinidad. Oh, I'm not sure Tito can get up. He's got the desire. He's never been knocked out. This fight is over. Steve Smoker stops it.
The winner by way of technical knockout tonight, earning his place in boxing history as he is now the undisputed middleweight champion of the world, Bernard, the executioner.
I don't see no evil.
Hopkins.
Right. That's right. Look. J.